I'm Jane Piper, and I'm a rape survivor, and I've spoken publicly about my story quite a bit to different audiences, both online and in person, and I feel it's really important to share my story because we don't hear a lot from rape survivors. We hear a lot about rape. We hear a lot about the criminal aspect of it in the news, but we don't actually hear too much from rape survivors, and so I feel it's really important to add my voice to the conversation and create a wider dialogue about the topic of sexual assault. And it's really important to me to do so. And I've been doing it for a long time. And this is actually, this week is the marks the 17th anniversary of my rape. And every year I like to do something special for myself just to celebrate my healing, to celebrate that I survived, that I'm still kicking. And this year I'm gonna start a series of videos because of COVID and the pandemic. We're all locked up and our lives are different. Everything's going crazy and there's no audiences to speak to. So I'm going to go online and do these little videos and tell little snippets of my healing process over the years. And today, what I really want to talk about is what's most important to me through my healing process is my sense of humor. Now, it seems like a weird thing when you're talking about rape to talk about humor. It's not funny. There's nothing funny about rape, but it's what got me through. And I want to tell you a little story that actually took place the day of the day I was raped 17 years ago. And just to give you a bit of backstory, I was raped in a grocery store parking lot in Santa Monica, in Brentwood, California. In Los Angeles, and I was pulled into my car and raped in my car, and then the person tried to take me away, and I jumped out of the car window as he was driving away, and I ran into the supermarket and I told the people there that I had been raped and can they please call the police, and from there I went to the hospital. And if you fast forward a few hours later, I was in the hospital. And I was really beaten severely and I was really messed up. My face was quite mangled and I looked awful. My hair had been pulled out in knots and it was all matted and falling out in clumps. And so what they had me carry the sheet around to catch the DNA, because basically it's, you know, they're just collecting evidence the whole time. And they wanted to collect any DNA that might be coming out in my hair. And so I'm carrying this sheet around to collect all of the DNA. So I had to get a jaw x-ray done. So the x-ray technician put the sheet with all of my hair pieces in it on a chair, and we were doing the x-ray. And then a nurse comes into the room, and all of a sudden she makes a beeline to the chair with the sheet on it, picks up the sheet, and we just all look at it and gasp. And everyone's just silent. And then suddenly I said, well, this is why O.J. Simpson is still walking the streets. And then I started laughing. And no one said anything. And my boyfriend gasped. He was horrified. He shushed me, I think, because I think it was just so inappropriate and no one got it. And the poor guy ran out of the room, the x-ray tech, with his imaginary tail between his legs. And the nurse just kind of looked confused as people explained to her what I had said. Anyway, it didn't really go over. The joke didn't land. It was not my moment. But a few hours later, they were doing the rape kit. And this is a really more than private examination. They take photographs of every inch of your body and basically document all of the bruising and all of the injuries. And it's so invasive and you feel violated and it's awful. And the nurses are all taking photographs and doing what they need to do. And all of a sudden, one of them started laughing. And then she just muttered to herself, that's why O.J. Simpson's still walking the streets. And she starts laughing. And she explains the story to all of the other nurses. And they all laughed. And I felt like they got me. And I had this moment of being validated. And I knew that I was going to be okay. And this is so important after you experience violence like I did, that you feel like you're going to be okay. And with me, it was brought by humor. I was able to bring lightness to the dark because of my sense of humor, and it really helped me. Now, I don't think that everyone should go around making jokes about their rape. It's not necessarily the funniest thing in the world. It's not funny at all. But it's really important to me to bring light to the darkness because I've had some really, really dark periods. And this experience ruined my life, but I have gotten back to a new life that is better than before, and I'm happy about who I am because of my sense of humor. It's a huge part of it. So if you're interested in any of this, if my story's interesting to you, you're welcome to go to my website, janepiper.com, or you can go to the Facebook page that we run Jane Piper's This Is Rape, Stories from Survivors, and join us there. And I really appreciate it so much. And I'll be doing more videos like this coming up soon. And thank you so much.